So now that we have multiple solutions, mm-hmm. I guess it's time to come up to a decision and to come up with one solution, right?
That's right. So the decide stage is important in helping filter down the ideas that were collected. The previous stage, which is about diverging, has made it so that everyone has created a lot of sketches and they're starting to develop some passion and attachment to the things that they have. During the decide stage, we ask the team to put their ideas on the board so everyone can see them. At that point, we ask people to remain silent. We call this process Zen voting. Just like in a Zen spirit, you want to be quiet and consider things in a reflective manner. During this process, we ask people to review what the sketches are before anyone gets to bias them with their opinions. So, as they review the sketches that other people have created, they start thinking, what do they like about the other solutions? And you're always curious. I made this. What did the others make? It's fun to see that. After everybody has voted, it is time to actually discuss things in person. So something that's not natural to teams happen, that's really valuable. People had individual personal time to be creative. Then they had personal time to view results, and they had time to consider and cast their vote before anyone else could say, I think this is important, and so they got biased. So now that they have gone through that, they're ready to look at things as a community. As a community, the team reviews what are the ideas, what are the most popular ones, and then quickly they get to see, well, clearly some things rise to the top and maybe others are less important. So their minds is changed based on what the community has decided. Research shows that this community-based voting can be more powerful than the decisions of a single expert. For example, if you have a horse race and experts betting on the horses, and if you have a crowdsourcing solution in which you're testing who is making, a whole crowd is making predictions on who will win, it is likely that the crowd might often beat the experts over what you would usually think is that the experts will be more powerful. Crowdsourcing a decision makes the team decide faster, and it helps the team often gather the wisdom of everyone who is involved.
So what could go wrong in this stage?
What could go wrong in this stage? Decisions are a crucial aspect of what teams do. In fact, the life of a team is made of all of the decisions that they make. So we cannot pretend that this is an easy process for teams. Things can go wrong if one person is trying to overpower and put the opinions over others. This happens all the time. This is why we have a leader of a sprint. The leader of the sprint is watching the entire group. They want to make sure that the introverts and the extroverts are heard, the designers and the engineers, the CEO and the intern. Everyone could have a great decision at this point.
So at this stage, we look at the solutions, we vote, and we make a call.
That's right.